Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage Wishbone Ash. Some monitors. Thank you so much. There we go. We'll be right back. so much.
We're doing good. We're good. Yeah. We'll play you some old songs in a minute.
Thank you. thank you. What a great little town you have here. So is it Boca Raton, or is it Boca? Or is it, as the English would say, Boca? Yeah. Anyway, it's really nice to be in the sunshine, away from wet and windy Britain. So we're on the second day of our tour, which is the southern portion of our tour. We just did the northeast and the midwest, and yeah, this is groovy. So we figure you want to hear some older material, some of the 70s stuff, because you're all from the 70s. Here we go. Thank you.
A slave, how could I be? A soldier.
Thank you, folks. All those songs, plus the next one, they were from an album from 1972 called Argus. Thank you. And amazingly, because like I'm really old, and I'm much older than I look, actually. So this album is 50 years old, and it was our third album, yeah. 50, and it's 50 years old this year. So we're kind of like celebrating that. It's going to be a beatbox set coming out to commemorate that particular album, because it was a kind of a classic, made the number one in the UK and so forth. And that's when we started coming to the United States. And you guys discovered us and just propelled the thing forward, you know. There used to be a thing, thank you very much, there used to be. There used to be a thing in Britain, you know, like if you were a band, there were a lot of amazing bands in the early 70s, and the big thing, we used to meet in these rest stops, and we'd all be sitting around at 2 o'clock in the morning drinking coffee, shit coffee, by the way, and we'd be going, yeah, wouldn't it be great one day to make it, you know, and making it was coming to America. America. And so so the first show that the band did back in, I think it was just before this album actually, was opening for The Who. And yeah, and so we opened for The Who in Mississippi River Festival. I never played such a big crowd, it was like 35,000. And then we went on the road with The Who for, I don't know, 10 days or something. And Moon was at his peak at that point. And I'm in bed one night with my wife, actually, yes. And Moon broke into our room with a submachine gun. And he goes, your money or your wife? So, yeah, I'm just reliving the 70s right now. I mean, but those were great days, you know. That was rock and roll by then. So anyway, we went on to tour the States many, many times. We're still touring. We're still enjoying it. Thank you. So, and in kind of commemoration of those memories, this is a song called Sometime World. Met a man who felt the same way.
Thank you.
Well, we never stopped putting albums out. In fact, the last but one album was an album called Blue Horizon. We'd like to play a song from that. Yeah, you know it. You know it. Awesome. It's kind of appropriate tonight. It's called Way Down South.
Thank you.
So excited. Okay, so this next piece of music is from our latest album, which we produced this album just before COVID hit. So we really didn't get a chance to promote it. Did anyone hear it? It's an album called Coat of Arms.
Yeah! Right! Yeah! Right!
I love you, man. Awesome, thank you. It's an esoteric piece there. And anyway, we wrote this song, it's a kind of protest song. And Mark and I went to France, to a town called Saint-Étienne, and we got together and wrote this song there in between visiting vineyards. But because that's what rock stars do, you know. Play a little, drink a little wine, play a little music, if you're lucky. But anyway, we wrote it in France, and the concept was, at that time, you know, the rainforests were burning down. They're still fucking burning down, you know. And so there were the indigenous people were banding together, and they were trying to protest the Bolsonaro government at the time. So without getting too political, that was what that song was about. But then, of course, the latest crisis happened, and the words are so unbelievably potent, I think, personally, on the song, for the song. And so I'd like to dedicate this song to the people of Ukraine. We're just so fortunate being here enjoying music. And by the way, thanks for bringing live music back. It's been a really rough time for musicians, and everybody's trying to find their place in the world, and you guys are too, I'm sure, with your businesses and everything else you do. And of course, music, as we knew it, was a business. Now it's all free, you know. But that's cool, you know, because we still enjoy it. So, but anyway, thank you. We stand as one. Here we go. We'll be right back. That's Mark Abrams on the guitar. Give it up. And while we're at it, please say hello to Mr. Bob Skeen on the bass. Our newest friend and drumist, Mr. Mikey Truscott on the drums. Yeah. This tour is it's called the Phoenix Rising Tour, so you know, like the, you know, the legend of the Phoenix. Yeah, you know, you went to school, right? So basically, we thought that was a good title for the tour, because not only you know, it's like rebirth, yeah, we're all rebirthing here, and with music, live music, but it's also the title of one of our best known songs from actually, 1970, I think. This is unbelievable. So, we don't always play it, but we're going to play it tonight. And it features Mark on the guitar, and everybody, really. But we're going to take you out. Well, not take you out, literally. We're going to take you to the end of a great evening. And so this is kind of our last song. Kind of. Well, it's a very long song. They were in the 70s. Do you remember that? Albums would be like, you know, six songs. And we were free to do whatever we wanted. It was great. They even paid you for it, too. We spent all the money on drugs and sex and lost it all. But they were great times. So, Phoenix is the song. Here we go. Thank you, folks. You guys rock. Thank you. Thank you. I can't believe we haven't been here before, you know. Guys are so nice. Everyone's been so hospitable. Thank you.
Thank you.
folks. You've been an awesome audience. We really appreciate it. Good night. Thank you.